Customer feedback can give you insights on satisfaction, bugs, and the success of new implementations. You may even find opportunities for product development you otherwise might have missed. But to make informed decisions, you can't just collect data. You have to analyze it. I'm Sabina, a content manager at Survicate. In this video, I'm going to show you that you don't need much skills or prior knowledge to be able to analyze survey results.
If you send a survey with Survicate, all the results will populate in real time in the dashboard. You will have a ready and up-to-date survey report at all times. To find your report, find your survey in the library and click on responses. For every survey you collect, you'll have the total number of responses, dates of those responses on a chart, the date of the last response in the UTC time zone, your completion rate, basically how many people answered all of the questions in the survey, survey views, and the actual responses to your questions. Depending on the kind of questions you included in your survey, you'll get bar charts, graphs, or something like this that represents rating scales, including satisfaction and NPS questions. The Survicate survey report is very interactive and user-friendly. You can sort data right here without needing to use any spreadsheet software. You can use filters to sort data by date, answer, or respondent attributes. You'll be able to collect different key demographics, such as email addresses, names, browser information, if you configure a distribution method. Watch our survey report video to discover all of the features in this tab. There you'll also see how to set up custom notifications in Slack or in your email app. For example, you can trigger custom notifications and always immediately be alerted when an unhappy customer leaves a response. This is what it could look like in Slack. And this is an email notification about the same result. Okay, so that's your report, but how do you actually analyze survey data? Let's go through the five steps. Note down any patterns you see in your research. Try to find surprising numbers or peculiar correlations of data. Track when you made new implementations and any other changes to your product or service. Did satisfaction ratings spike, or do you see troughs immediately after some changes? That could tell you a lot about the success or failure of a certain adaptation. Step number two, consider the limitations of your research. Many beginner researchers make the mistake of taking their results at face value. Imagine you redesigned your website and satisfaction levels increased. Was this the only change you made? Or perhaps you employed a very efficient customer service agent at more or less the same time. In order to avoid this correlation versus causation mistake, think about the ways in which your data collection isn't perfect. Is your completion rate low? Is your survey sample too general? Was the timing of the survey or the questions biased in any way? To avoid making the mistake I just described, you could also take advantage of our transactional surveys that are triggered right after key touch points.
Step number three, pose hypotheses. Use your team management software or productivity app to store all potential explanations of data spikes and troughs. What might seem not so important now might be actually part of a very interesting pattern later on. Number four, discuss what these insights might reveal with your team. Is some abnormality a recurring trend? Are you always getting more sales in January? Discuss these ideas with your team members to find the best ways of taking advantage. What's more, talking to other members of your team will give you a fresh perspective on the results. Step number five, if you can't reach a conclusion, give it some time. If there is a result or pattern that you can see but can't find the reason for it or the source of it, write it down and then correlate it with your future survey results. What isn't obvious now may be very apparent in the future. By following these steps, you'll be able to effectively analyze your results and use the insights gained to make informed decisions. Another way to analyze survey results is to use statistical methods. This can include calculating means, medians, modes, as well as performing A/B tests on your software. You can even connect Survicate to tools like SmartLook and then pair your survey results with session recordings or heat maps. But Survicate integrates with many data analysis tools, including Mixpanel, Amplitude, Salesforce, and Google Sheets. And let's focus on that last one. It's a very popular option among our customers. Survicate not only allows you to export results in XLS and CSV formats, but also Google Sheets that update in real time. To connect a survey with Google Sheets, go to your Connect tab. Find Google Sheets on the list of integrations, click Connect if you haven't yet, and then you can either add a new sheet or create a new one. You can also send past responses if you've already collected data. And in case you want to do some housekeeping there, let's have a look at three ways of sorting data in Google Sheets. These are the results to an NPS survey. Let's first remove the blank rows to make it more pleasing to the human eye. So the first thing we want to do is select our four columns, and this is our range of data. Then you go to Data, create a filter, and then you can see these filter icons pop up in the top row. So then you click on the filter, and you can see a list of all the values we have kind of available, not counting duplicates, in this column. And whatever you unclick, those will be hidden from view. We are going to click blanks, and then the only rows that will remain are those that actually have a numerical value. Initially, the data ended at row 41, but when we actually apply that filter, you can see this is still 41, but we are missing some rows. So for example, from 35 to 38, these must have been blank. By using a filter, you're not removing any data, you're just hiding it from view. If you want to manipulate the data a bit more, I would suggest pasting it into a new sheet and making sure you are pasting the values only. Let's just make the columns a bit wider so that we can see what's happening. And just wrap the first row, because that's also more pleasing to the human eye. Now, let's have a look at what we have left. We still have some blank cells, but that was not the goal, not to have any blank cells. It was just to remove the empty rows. Now we can count how many respondents skipped the follow-up questions. And to do this, we're going to use the formula count blank. So you can use any cell to do this, but we're just going to use each cell at the bottom of the column. So let's test this. You paste the formula count blank, open up your brackets, and you give the range. And this is just a test because we just removed all the rows that were blank in this column. So basically we know there are no blank cells in this column. So this should pop up as zero. It did. And then we can drag it across the other columns and we can see how many people skip the follow-up question. But my favorite thing to do in any spreadsheet software, but in Google Sheets as well, is conditional formatting. Let's go back to the NPS question where all the answers are provided in numerical values. We're going to set the format of this column to integer numbers. So what you do is you select your column, format, number, and you can see integers right here. And you can see all the numbers jump to the right side of the column. Now select the column again, go to format, conditional formatting, and we are going to set up three rows. The NPS question is answered on a scale between 0 and 10. Customers that choose 0 and 6 are detractors, so unsatisfied customers. Customers who choose 7 and 8 are passives, so kind of neutral about your product or service. And then 9 and 10 are promoters, your happiest customers. Let's use conditional formatting to be able to determine the distribution of these three groups at a glance. So, as I said, we're going to set up three rows, and let's start with promoters. So we have our column selected. Then we are going to choose greater than or equal to, and we're going to do 9. So 9 and 10 are going to pop up as green. And on here you can see on the left that this is working already. Done. We're going to set up another rule. This is for passives. So we're going to choose is between, and let's choose 7 and 8. And then let's choose like a yellow. And you can see those 7s and 8s are already yellow on the left. And the last rule for detractors, so less than or equal to 6, so 0 to 6. And we're going to make them red, well, pink. And you can see every number in here was conditionally formatted, so you can very quickly see how many of each group you have. You can even connect your Google Sheets with Google Data Studio to create graphs and bar charts and recognize data much faster. Of course, you can also just look at your Survicate survey report. The graphs will be there waiting for you, and you can use filters to sort the data and organize it in any way you like.